Hello, it's lovely to meet you. My name is Scarlett.
Hi, Scarlett.
Can you talk to me a little bit about how you use sound and image in the film to dramatise the inner conflict of the characters?
That's a great question. I haven't been asked that one before, so I really like that question. I think for me, what I brought to Testament of Youth as its director, I wanted it to be really like subjective, emotional, her perspective on events, so that you're locked into Vera Brittain's mind. You know, there's not a scene without Vera Brittain in it. And so I think what's unique about this film and doesn't make it feel like a conventional period drama is just how subjective it is. And I think it makes people feel, as a result, incredibly close to Vera. They really sort of grieve with her, celebrate with her, and strengthen with her. And that's the way the images work in the film.
And what about sound?
Well, sound to me is incredibly important. It's often underestimated, but you know what we have is very... I wanted the music, for example, to be very controlled and restrained, not melodramatic, not Hollywood. You know, I felt, let people find their own emotions in the film. And the other thing about the sound was to find, was to be very subtle with it, keep it very real. I come from documentaries, so for me, it's really important that sound doesn't swamp the film. Keep the performances alive, don't let the sound take over.
I think sound is very underestimated in films. It really makes the film. So this is a film essentially about youth in a time when their youth was denied. Do you think that this is relevant to contemporary culture in the sense that, you know, you could say that our youth has been denied through things like the media and
the great crash of 2008? You could say, you know, young people can't afford to buy property now. You know, I think there is an element where young people aren't being listened to. And I think the important thing about the film for young people is to say, make your voices heard. Don't give in, stick to what you believe in. And for older people, is listen to this young girl. You know, she wants to go to Oxford. You are wrong to even object to that. And they see that in the film. And I think in the same way, I think older people need to be aware that young people, they need to make their mark on the world. Give them the space to do that.
Yeah, I agree. And finally, this is actually just a little bit of a fun question. What was your favourite film of 2014?
Right. Cool.
Wow.
Go on, Naomi.
I think my favourite film of 2014, oh gosh.
As a director. Because I love directors. I always think they're really the vision of film.
My mind goes blank. What was my favourite film of 2014? I saw lots. I can't even think of them now. My head's so in this film. Can I admit that?
It's okay. You can forget that one. Okay. Thank you very much. Lovely to meet you. Thank you.